Hello, everybody. Welcome in. Trevor Lane here for LakersNation.com. The newest Laker, Christian Wood, agreeing to a two-year deal with the Purple and Gold and has just released his first statement about joining the team. Joining me is Mark Gunnels from LakersNation.com. Mark, what are your thoughts on the signing, Christian Wood to the Lakers?
Yeah, you know, we talked about this potentially happening for months now, and, you know, I'm so glad it just finally happened. We were talking about getting a backup big for AD. You know, you got Jackson Hayes there, but you need another guy to fill out that roster. And you bring in a talented guy. I mean, the guy can shoot from the outside, put the ball on the ground a little bit, has some upside as a rim protector as well. So I love it. I mean, he's also a local kid. He's from the area. So I think it's good all around.
Yeah, absolutely. I think it's a no-brainer move for the Lakers. Now, Wood did just release this statement through Mark Spears of Anscape, said, "I've always wanted to be a Laker. I know we can win a championship. Communication with a coach is a big key. Coach Ham and I go back to our Milwaukee days, and we've had great conversations every day about this opportunity. He believes in me and told me I'll be playing a big role and knows what I can do. I'm looking forward to this and for sure motivated after what Dallas did." Lots to unpack there. I do want to note that according to Jovan Buha of The Athletic, the expectation, according to those within the Lakers, is that Christian Wood will come off the bench for LA and that Rui Hachimura will be the one in the starting lineup. We've debated for a while whether it should be Rui, Vando, lots of different options. But currently, and all of this will have to play out in training camp, the plan is for Christian Wood to come off the bench. But Mark, what do you take away from this statement?
Well, first of all, like I mentioned, he is from the LA area. So it's not surprising to see that he always wanted to be a Laker growing up here. During obviously the heydays, and then, you know, just the aura of being a Laker. Everybody wants to be a Laker, whether they want to admit it or not. They all want to be one. And then as far as winning the championship, yeah, we talk about it all the time, man. This team is built to win it. You bring in back most of the guys, the core guys for sure. You're bringing in some nice guys to fill in off the bench, Gabe Vincent. Now you're bringing in Christian Wood, probably going to come off the bench as well. I really like the direction this team's going in. And then the fact that him and Coach Ham already have a relationship, right? The fact that he's already going to know what they expect from him, things of that nature. They have a good relationship. That's always good to translate off the court to on the court when you believe in your head coach and vice versa. And then about the Mavs, I mean, you know, there was times where they were saying he's unplayable down there. You know, I'm not exactly sure what all happened behind closed doors in Dallas, but obviously there's a little friction there, a little bad blood from a Christian Wood side of the story. And, you know, you may see them in the playoffs now with the Lakers. So,
oh boy, wouldn't that be quite a matchup? Yeah. Start circling the calendars for Lakers versus Mavs, because you know Christian Wood's going to have something to prove. Yeah, I mean, clearly he's not happy with Dallas after they decided they were going to part ways with him. They weren't even going to offer him a contract. What else was going on behind the scenes? We know he wasn't given a starting role last season. Didn't seem like he was in their long-term plan. So there's some frustration there towards the Dallas Mavericks. Interesting to hear him putting that out there about the Mavs. But then the Darvin Ham piece here, not only having a, you know, and maybe this is also a little bit of a dig at the Mavs, communication with the coach is key. Were there issues between Jason Kidd and Christian Wood? Again, things that we'll probably learn more about as time goes on. But the bit about Darvin Ham believes in me and told me I'll be playing a big role and knows what I can do. There's a positive and a negative with this. The positive being that Darvin Ham sees a role for Christian Wood and sees a way that he can really help this team, because obviously he wouldn't be telling him that otherwise. Clearly, there is a role for Christian Wood to step into. I believe it makes sense for him to come off the bench and for him to be that floor spacer potentially alongside AD or in place of Anthony Davis. He's a guy who can come in and give you buckets in a hurry. So that, I think, is a very important role that Christian Wood is going to be playing with the Lakers this season. But also that Darvin Ham is telling him he'll be playing a big role. That could become an issue if someone beats him out for minutes. Like, what if Jared Vanderbilt's offensive game blossoms and suddenly Christian Wood sees his minutes cut? What if Jackson Hayes comes in and plays extremely well and Christian Wood's minutes get cut as a result? Is that a problem, a la a few years back when Dennis Schroeder first came to the Lakers and was told, hey, you're going to be a starter? And he said very plainly that he wanted to start. Coming off the bench wasn't something he wanted to consider. He was coming in with that mindset. So this is something to keep an eye on too here, that clearly Christian Wood believes he's stepping into a big role with the Lakers. If that doesn't come to fruition, potentially that could be an issue down the road.
Yeah, and I think the word big is where you have the issue and where I could see a problem with as well. You know, there's no problem with him having a role, but a big role. That sounds like maybe it's just a under-the-table agreement or a promise. And could that cause some type of friction? Because like you said, what if a Vando does outplay him, or, you know, Jackson Hayes or anybody? But will the fact that they have a potential agreement still give the minutes to Christian Wood regardless? You know, like, I don't know. So that is very interesting to hear him say the word big before a role there, because he will have a role, but big is a pretty strong wording there. And I can see what you're saying when it comes to that.
Well, and that doesn't necessarily look at everyone's definition of a big role can be different. So yeah. 20 minutes a night could be a big role for one player, and another player could say that's not a big enough role for me. So I don't mean to cause any alarm here or anything like that. It's just something to keep an eye on. Obviously, Christian Wood is coming in with the expectation that he is going to be playing some kind of significant minutes, and he's going to be an important piece to the team. And I think that's good for him to be bought in, but just maybe something to consider if things don't go according to plan. But again, that's part of where having him on a veteran minimum contract is a good situation. But again, right now, all is positive. Nothing has happened at this point. Everything is good. And Christian Wood, I think, is a bargain of a deal, and that Darvin Ham clearly sees a role for him and believes he can help this team win. I think he absolutely can. It's all very, very exciting. Just something to keep an eye on, that this is our first real introduction to Christian Wood. His first major statement, aside from saying he always wanted to be a Laker on Twitter last night or on X, this being the first thing we hear that he is expecting to have a big role, just something to kind of file away and keep in mind. But everything else, pretty good. And look, he has a lot riding on this season. So him coming in with something to prove and motivated, I think that's a very good thing, both for the Lakers and for Christian Wood himself.
Yeah, and I want to say this real quick too. I'm glad you mentioned buying in, because that's what he's going to have to do on this team. Because if you look at his career so far, he's never been on a team that had a legitimate chance of actually winning a championship. Yeah, he's been on a couple playoff teams and things like that, but nobody where you thought they actually could go all the way and play into June. Well, that's not the case with this team. This team just came off a Western Conference Finals run, and they got better on paper. You kept your core guys, like I said. You added in a Christian Wood, a Gabe Vincent, other guys like that. So I really, Torian Prince. So I really think this team is built. So he's going to have to buy in. You know, there may be nights where he plays 25, 30 minutes, but it may be nights where he plays only 10 to 15, depending on the matchup. And he has to be okay with that. And I think he is, because the fact that he's always wanted to be a Laker. He mentioned the word championship in this statement, so he understands the excitement here. So I really do think he's bought in, and we're going to see it this season.
That's right. That's right. Hopefully we see that all play out, and the Lakers do wind up contending here for a championship. As Christian Wood said, they can win a championship. I think that is very much in the cards for the Lakers this season. But Lakers Nation, give us your thoughts in the comments down below. Don't forget to subscribe right here to the Lakers Nation YouTube channel. Ring that notification bell as well. Till next time, everybody. See ya, and stay safe.